HOA is an idea developed by Satan himself, Homeowners Association. A couple who lives in Raleigh, North Carolina, they have been harassed by their HOA, according to them, because they have a Black Lives Matter sign inside of their window. There's more to this story. Let's put up the picture of Lindsey. Really interesting. Lindsey says her wife, Connie, put up the sign when they moved in more than a year ago. All right. Lindsey said, we placed it inside the window, not outside. We were trying to follow the rules and we know where we live. And we're not trying to get away with anything, okay? What does the sign read? Let's put it up. Here's the sign. The sign has the egregious message of, in this house, we believe Black Lives Matter. Women's rights are human rights and no human is illegal. Love is love, science is real, kindness is everything. What? They had the audacity to say what? Which part of that do you think got them in trouble? Was it the kindness is everything part? Maybe it was love is love. No. Black Lives Matter. In a letter from the HOA to Lindsey, it says, and I quote, signs are not permitted to be visible in the community. Please remove the signage. The article in violation says, no owner shall display, hang, store, or exhibit any signs outside of the dwelling so as to be visible outside of the lot. Lindsey says, to test the theory that her and her partner are being targeted, they are going to get a garden flag for their yard with the same message. It's almost like a litmus test. If they suddenly have a problem with the garden sign, now we have no doubt that we are being targeted. You should know based on the reading of the rules that you're being targeted, madam. It's unfortunate. And thank you for the allied relationship. We need more like you. And we build coalition. All right, so that's why we are going to defend coalition members like yourself every time on Indisputable. Now, it's clear based on the reading of their own rules that in order for you to be in violation, your sign must be outside of the dwelling, clearly in the rules. If they have a challenge, a problem with you having a sign inside of your dwelling, well, they need to change the rules, all right? Let's put up a picture of the CEO of the HOA's management company. His name is Derek Green. So if the couple fails to comply by July 1st, they could be fined $40 a day. This is the couple's third notice of a supposed violation. The others involved a fire pit and a portable collapsible fence. Lindsey says other homes have similar violations but have not been punished. All right, they have similar things. No punishment. Why? Because it doesn't say black in it. That's why. All right. Derek Green, CEO of the HOA's management company, said that the governing documents are, and I quote, enforced equally across the entire community. If this was a security sign or a contractor sign, they would have received the same violation. It has nothing to do with the content of the sign or the people that of that residence. Okay. According to the residents, Mr. CEO, you're not telling the truth. And I do find it ironic that things inside of your home, you got to think about this, all right? Because you got to be careful. Just because it's a rule. Now, let's say the HOA creates a rule and says you can't put it inside of your home. Now, damn it, HOAs routinely go too far. You mean to tell me I do not have the authority to say what goes on the inside of my home? I don't have that ability. You mean the HOA can regulate that? Okay. Dina, these HOA rules are pretty strong and many times they do uphold in court, but I've seen some people successfully fight HOAs and their ridiculous notions of community standards. What are your thoughts here?
So earlier in the show, I was talking about how the sign on the business, if it was on a neighbor, they have free speech, right? And you couldn't do anything about it. HOA is the one exception to that because they have rules. They say, if you're going to live in our community, basically we can restrict those types of things. Now, this is an example, obviously, where it's like upsetting because their sign is really all about like love and kindness. But if you had a neighbor and they were putting a Nazi sign up and you weren't living in an HOA, you really couldn't have them paint over it or take down a sign because people can put up whatever free speech signs they want in their house. I think we talked about that time where the neighbor was having that offensive radio playing on his loop in his house and they couldn't do anything about it because he had free speech. If they were in an HOA community, it could get shut down. So it kind of cuts both ways. You lose a lot of your rights when you're in an HOA, like frankly, you just do. But are you willing to do that? Because maybe you don't want to be across from a neighbor who's got this huge, horrible sign up. I've seen them also take down signs when they're inside the garage, but they're really visible outside of it. So HOAs are their own beast. It's a little bit of a delicate balance. It just depends, like, what are you willing to give up in order to maybe not have to deal with your neighbors, maybe putting up offensive things?
You know, it is interesting. So let's go back to the reading of the HOA rule that clearly says outside of your dwelling, that the physical structure or the sign has to be outside of your dwelling and visible. So it is visible. There's no doubt about that. But let's go back to elements, right? So it has to be what? It doesn't say A or B, all right? If it's inside, it seems to be silent to that. It seems to be no actual wording for that. And so I see a loophole here. And if they don't like the loophole, they have to change the rule. And then if they change the rule to specifically say inside of your home, how deep does that go? Does that mean that something that's in the back of your home that can technically be seen by somebody because your window is open that day, is that now a violation of their rule? How far can the HOA go in enforcing a simple rule about what you have inside of your home?
You know, it's tough because the HOA, I mean, they can, you know, I mean, there's non-free speech things, right? Like what you can paint on your house, even just the color of your house, they can restrict. Obviously, speech is the most important, but they're basically saying you're signing into this contract by living in the neighborhood. And so you're right, it says on the inside, but if they have, like, I know this person said, you know, they weren't applying the law equally. I think that after the 2020 election, I know a lot of HOA communities, people were putting up a lot more signs. And it's possible this community kind of tried to be more proactive with the signs. But if she finds that other people, I would have her document it, right? You know, if other people's signs are being left out, then it's an unequal enforcement. But if they have kind of been more proactive because it's becoming so hostile with all these competing signs, you know, that's a tough one. But yeah, I mean, like I said, it's the free speech. It's the one area where homeowners are restricted in their speech on what they put on their house.
So very interesting. All right, so if there's a development, we'll bring it to you. I hope they continue to fight. Take them to court if you can. Show the unequal application of the enforcement and see if something will actually stick. All right.